Good morning. Welcome back. Today, we're going to be working on my newly acquired 2004 Volvo S60R. I will make a video on the backstory on this. I flew out to Chicago after weeks of searching on the internet, trying to find a nice clean one. This one here had 56,000 miles at the time of purchase. Overall good shape, couple dings and light scratches. I did my best to remediate them, but for a daily driver, it's nice that I don't have to baby this thing as much as I would my GT350. So, in store for today, gonna be installing a new 3-inch turbo back exhaust. The exhaust is from a company called IPD, and the downpipe is from a company out in Massachusetts called Revolve. I never heard of them before, but they were kind of the middle price point between the IPD catback downpipe, and some of the other more expensive ones. So, just a quick word of warning, I don't have power at my house right now. Been on a generator now for the better part of 2 whole days. So, gonna get this thing up in the air, take a look, and we'll get started.
So starting from the back, removal of the exhaust, I don't expect too many problems. It's a little rusty. Moving along here, I'm sure I'm gonna have a hard time getting rid of these bolts here where the flange from the cat meets the exhaust, but I got a nut splitter. We'll just crack those open and destroy them and replace them with the new hardware that comes with the kit. I think the biggest struggle I'm gonna have is with the oxygen sensors, because I'm having trouble finding where exactly they route up. I know they're somewhere behind the transmission, but it looks like access is gonna be a huge pain. I think I'm gonna pop this front driver's wheel off and see if I can get some access that way. One of the leads for the oxygen sensor up here, it's about 4 feet long, goes up and over the engine, but once it's disconnected, I don't know, somewhere in there, it should come right out, and then we'll pop them into the new downpipe and put the cables back where they go and hopefully not break the connectors upon disassembly and reinstallation. So where do I want to start? Let's see here. I got some leaky angle gear here. Hopefully we'll remedy that before the winter comes. Looking around. I think I see where they go. So I'm gonna pop this wheel off. So I've located the connector. It is, I don't even think my hand bends that way. It is right about there. I know you can't see where I'm pointing, and I don't know that I'll be able to get the camera in there to get a good shot of it, but it looks like I have to pull a tab out and then pull a tab over to get these things out. So let me see if I can get a better camera angle. Otherwise, I'll just do it off camera and focus in on the connector once it's disconnected. So this one, see that little red plastic connector in there? Somehow that worked itself free, probably broken from a previous installation, but I'm gonna try to weasel my hand in there with this little pry tool and pop that little red tab off, and that should allow the connector to fall out. And then I'll have to do the same for the connector that's directly above it. So this one I'm working on now is for the oxygen sensor down below, and the other one is for the one up top behind the turbo. Okay, change of plans, because I'm getting a weird vibe that these connectors are going to start breaking the second I pull them off. So I can't really get the leverage that I need to crack. Let's see if we can get a picture of it. To crack that oxygen sensor loose where it stands. So I think I'm going to work on these flange bolts. I am gonna disconnect the oxygen sensor up top where it stands and then lower this down and then maybe rest it on a bench or something and then crack that oxygen sensor loose in place. These are about $100 each. I don't think I'll snap these wires. I don't condone doing this normally, but I think it's the best course of action at this time. So let's get started on these flange bolts and work our way back up. Easy.
later.
All right, I gave up. I just cut it off. It's all rusted. It's not worth anything anyway. So now I'm gonna try to work this out while it's still kind of secured into the subframe here. So, I think it's time to heat that little piece up. Nope. All right. Change of plans. Ow, hot. Get this guy. Oh, yeah. All right. Let's try that again. Got him. Nice. All right. Be back in a minute. All right. So, flange is cut. Oxygen sensor is backed out. I kept it twisted and hanging over here. That way, just put it in the other way. Battery's running low, so I'll make this quick. I'm gonna take the rest of the back half of this exhaust out since I'm committed. Doesn't make a difference if I work on the downpipe or the back half because I'm screwed either way. So I'm gonna change batteries in the camera and I'm gonna get started on removing the rest of this. Be right back. Put that back in just to hold on to it. Okay, it's loose. Let's go to these here. That. One second. hurt your face.
All right, that should be out.
And my nuts. Saved it. Oh, but Jesus, that would have fucking hurt. Oh, Jesus. Oh, heavy girl. All right. Oh. Oh, heavy. 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 All right. Oh. Okay. Let's try that again. Oof. Watch your face. This is probably gonna fall on something. Heavy. All right, so I have to transfer these hangers to the new setup. I'll do that later. Let's go and lower this back down and take off the heat shield and the downpipe bolts. Let's go change views. All right, we're under the hood. We're gonna take off this strut tower brace. There's a bolt going through here that's gotta come out. And then these two 14 millimeters, I believe. Small size 15, large size 18 millimeter. And then behind here, we'll take off the heat shield. We'll back out the oxygen sensor, and then we'll back off the three nuts that hold in the downpipe. And
also think I forgot to put one on down here when I did some work earlier. Yep, it's a little loose. I have the third bolt, know where it is, so we'll put that back when we're done. All right, I had some trouble with the SD card. I had to transfer some files. You didn't miss anything. Took out the heat shield, and I dropped down the downpipe there. I'm gonna replace the gasket. I'm gonna transfer over the exhaust hangers to the new unit. Oops, something fell. And then we're just gonna go back and install this in reverse. All right, let's go get the new unit laid out, and we'll transfer the components over. All right, we're gonna hang this exhaust gasket on. Hook one. Oh, it's gonna be one of those days where this doesn't fit. All right, hold on, I need two hands. Okay, two hands were required. Gasket's on, it can only go on one way. Apparently that, the layout of those studs is in such a way where the gasket can't be rotated onto each stud. There's a specific pattern and alignment that needs to take place. So that's all done. I'm now gonna feed the downpipe. Oh, that's the old one. I'm gonna feed the new downpipe through this hole, rest it on there, hand tight some nuts on there to keep it in place, and then we'll start reassembling. Okay, so this is the finished product. I had some file corruption issues, so I lost a lot of the install, but I think the best installation video is the one from IPD itself. I'll leave the link for that below. Downpipe is in, feed it in through here, hand tight the nuts up there onto the back of the turbo. Right there, they came on and off real easy. Just shoot them with a little PB blaster and they should come out, no problem. Put this cross brace back, tighten these four bolts, and then work your way back. Let's see, it's right here at the flange. This is like a little stubby insert piece. Bolt it here, tighten the bolts, and then as you install everything, just leave it loose for justification. Here's the resonator, slides over, install the clamp, come back this way, feed in this section of pipe here and install the two exhaust hangers, and then you can kind of just guide it in and then just loosely clamp it in place. I've heard stories that these rot out and rust really, really quick, especially here in the Northeast where we get salt in the wintertime. I have some higher quality band clamps. I'll swap them out when they rust out. It's not a big deal. But moving back here towards the muffler, started here on the hanger, rotate it in, leave it loose, and then you could put this tip on. I don't like this tip, to be honest with you. I'm gonna change this over to a, I think it's like a 5 or 6 inch oval RS4 style exhaust tip. I just gotta find the one that I'm looking for. I also don't like the way this clamp looks because it can only go in here facing the driver's side, because this hanger here, you know, gets in the way. So that is not great fit and finish by my standards. So this is gonna get swapped out as soon as I can find the parts I'm looking for. But yeah, other than that, it's in. I like it, it sounds good. It's not overly loud, it doesn't drone. So that's it. Appreciate you taking the look. Be well.